For this first solve, the scramble is given in the description. So you went for the white cross and you saw that the pieces were here, here, here and here. So the solution that you did was B, L prime, B prime, R, these two, now trying to insert this one, F, R, D prime, F prime, D prime to make the white cross. Now this cross solution had two major problems. First of all, it was very long, and the second was that the solution was not finger trick friendly. So I'll give you a better solution. You start like this, you keep the cube right here, start like this, and then you do R prime F to bring this and this into the cross region. Then you do D prime to move it opposite. Now 1, 2, these two are also opposite, then L, R to make them opposite. Now this one is right here, so D, L prime, D. So what this solution helps you is in finger tricks, and it's 8 moves, which is one move shorter than your solution, and also it preserves this F12 pair. So you can continue with that. So after this, while starting your F12, you did a UU prime to trying in search for pairs, which actually you shouldn't do. You should pause after the cross, look for the pieces, don't do random moves. That was my first tip for F12. Now for the first pair, what you did was U2 U prime R 2 prime U prime R U prime, and you inserted this pair into the back. So this solution was completely perfect for me. I had no problem with this pair. Now for the second pair, which was a green orange pair, what you did was take it back here. No, sorry. You did a U to bring it here. Then you did a L prime U L to insert this edge. Then you brought the corner here, took this out, rotated and inserted it into the back. Now there's a much better solution for this. Whenever you see this kind of a pair and both the centers are right here, keep it on the right side and do F, U, R, U prime, R prime, F prime. So this is a POLL, you might know that. So this forms this pair and you can directly insert it afterwards. So after inserting the second pair, you notice this free pair. But the thing was that while inserting this pair, you should have looked ahead to this pair, and maybe you paused for 0.5, 0.6 seconds to notice this pair and then insert it. So this is no problem. And for the fourth pair, you had this one and this one, and you inserted it in the very optimal way. Now, I think you should look at the exact finger tricks that you should use for it. You do R, U with the index, R prime, no regrip for the right hand, U to flick with your left hand, and the same R, U, R prime. So this is a regripless solution, and your OLL was pretty okay. You did it quite nice. The problem I had with your solution was mainly this E-perm. So the right finger trick that you should use for this is, first of all, rotate. Just notice the finger tricks. Till here you were exactly the same. Then you did this and you regrip to do this, which you shouldn't do. You should just do a push here, then this, and again a push here. So this makes it quite fast, you can see. With solve 2, the scramble is in the description again. Okay, so for the second scramble you did red cross. You notice that these two were already opposite to each other. This one is just an R2 away, and this would be UL2 and inserted. So you actually did the optimal solution, but I would just advise a simple finger trick that you could have improved here. You did R2 with this, regripped, and did U with this. So what actually you should have done was R2, push this, push with the left, then regrip this and do the D2 flick with your right hand. So this is very, very finger trick efficient actually. So for the first pair, what you did was a U prime. So I know that you know your U2 flicks with your left hand, so you should have done that right away. Then you did rotation and inserted this pair into the front. So the first advice would be rotate this way, although it involves more rotation, but it still is inserted into the back, which will eventually help you. Okay, so after inserting this one, you did L prime UL, and then you did 3 U's, rotated UL prime U prime L, then you rotated again to insert this into the back. So for this solution, I have a better F12 solution. So you were inserting this and this. So what you were facing this side, what you should have essentially done is rotate first, do a sledgehammer, which brings this into the top layer, move it here, take this one out like this so that these two can now be inserted into the left slot with F moves easily. And you could have actually rotated as well if you wanted. So for the third pair, what you did was you had these two, you separated them like this, which is actually the ideal solution, then insert it like this. But actually what you should have done was you had two more ways which would have been way more faster than this one, because you had to regrip like more times. So either you can rotate this way or you can rotate this way. I would prefer that you rotate this way. You do RU prime R prime, do a single rotation and insert it into the back. See, the solution is exactly the same, but the difference is in the finger tricks. So after inserting this third pair, for the fourth pair, you had this flip ditch. So what you did was you were facing this way. You did a U prime, came to this face. Now you did RU prime R prime U to take this edge out. Then you rotated. You have this pair right here, R prime U to R. Then you did a U and inserted it with a double flick. So this solution was nice considering the fact that you did this solution. There's a way better solution to this, which I'll be showing you now. So when you were about to do the fourth pair, you should have seen that this edge is flipped. So what I would prefer in this case, which is like around the same moves as the solution that you did, but it is way faster. So you do a sledgehammer, take this pair out, do R prime U2, R2, insert this pair and cancel into inserting the pair that you have taken out. So for the OLL, you had this P case, you rotated, you saw this case. So the ideal finger trick would be do this thumb flick without regripping, do with the index finger, no regrips, here, here and this. So this would be the ideal solution. And then you had the F-perm. So the finger tricks that you did in your F-perm were like pretty good, but I just want to focus one point. You did the F-perm finger tricks like this. At the end, what you should have done was, instead of doing with this finger, which actually comes in the way of this turn, you should have done the flick with this, like this, and the AUF with the thumb right here, because you've just done a move with this finger, so the AF should be with the thumb. Third solve also, the scramble is available in the description if you want to follow along. Okay, so for this scramble, you did orange cross. You saw that these two pieces were already solved. This piece was just an R2 away, and this piece had to be inserted right here. So what you did was, first you did an F2, then you did this to insert your this blue edge. So what I would suggest you instead, I believe this was the situation, right? Okay. So what how you should have started the solution was hold it in this position, do an L only, and then bring this cross edge right here on the top layer. So that when you insert this one is already matched, and you, with an F prime, you can just insert your cross piece. So for the first F2L pair, what you did was you did a random U, then you rotated U to U prime. You wasted moves like I suggested earlier also. Just look at the pairs, find the pairs, don't do random moves at all. So you did this, and then you inserted this blue yellow pair into the back, and then again you did some random moves like this. I don't know for what, but still there's a better solution for this pair. So after you were finished with the cross, you saw these two. What you should have ideally done was, you were right here, so you have rotated, you should have rotated, do a U2, then move this edge with the corner, do another rotation, LU2L prime, which inserts this pair into the back. It is efficient as well as fast. So after inserting this pair, you did some random L and U moves, and that took you to this situation. So after this, you noticed the green and yellow pair, this one. So what you did was, you moved this corner to the back, made the situation like this, then you did a U and inserted the pair in the back like this. Now I appreciate this insert, the wide F insert, but actually the solution could have been way better. So you had this pair right here. What you could have ideally done was move this corner here, take this edge out, do a wide D prime, and then insert it into the front, which completes the right slots, and you have this pair that you can insert while after rotating. So after inserting this pair with the wide F moves, you did a RU R prime. I think this was a random move. So what you could have ideally done was, so I have shown you this, how to do this pair in one of the previous solves. So you could have just gone and inserted it without any rotation. Pretty simple. I am sorry for that. Okay, so it was right here. So once you did the RU R prime, you had two options what you could have done right here. You went for this pair actually by separating them and then inserting it. So ideally what you should have done was do this pair like this, which makes up this pair also quite easy, and all the edges are still oriented. So what you did was, you took this pair, separated it like this, rotated and inserted into the back. So now for the last pair, what you did was, your last pair was right here, right? This one and this one. So what you did was, you took this piece out in the most random way that you could, which you shouldn't do. Then you separated them with F moves and inserted it. So this was, this solution had two major mistakes, and I'll go over them right now. First of all, if you were to do this solution in any way, then after you did this, as I had suggested in an earlier solve also, you should rotate, always do it with the R's, and then insert it. Now for the better solution to this pair would be, you do a U2, bring this edge here, and then match it with this corner with the lefty moves. So now you would have two options here, either to do the U prime L prime UL insert or the sledgehammer, but as you can see, this kind of block is already made, so it's better to do this normal insert. So after inserting this pair, you had this OLL, and you did it with only the half turn metric moves. What I would suggest is, You come to this face, do wide TOLL. Without regripping, move this with the left index and then do the standard T. The result is exactly the same as you did. It's a PLL skip, but this solution is like way faster than yours. You can see yourself for that.